Hello, this is Raphael Freeman from Running Our Typesetting, www.runningourtype.com. In this video, we're going to talk about how to set the top and bottom margin and the baseline grid to fit the text. So this has been a problem that I've had for a very long time, and it's taken me a little while to sit down and work out a way of solving this quickly and accurately rather than messing around. But let's start by showing you what the problem is. So we're going to start by creating a new document. And you're going to see the problem hopefully very quickly. So we've got a new document, and we're going to make it, let's say, 150 millimeters by 220 millimeters. And we're going to have some nice margins. We're going to start with a margin at the top, a margin at the bottom, and an inside and outside margin. And hey presto, we have our new design. We switch on the baseline grid. Now, what are we trying to do? The first thing is, we want, when we put text in here, for the grid, whatever this baseline grid, to be the same as the text. And the second thing that we want to do is we want to make sure that the bottom is exactly the same. I don't mind if this bottom margin now is a little bit less or a little bit more. Just want it to be on the baseline grid. Whether I actually snap my text to the baseline grid, I'll have to make a decision about that. But right now, I just want to make sure that I have everything working the way that I want. So the first step is to open up my little grid calculator. And this calculator is, by the way, anyone who's interested in it is able to can have it for free. I'm just going to take out all the values so that we've got a starting point, a clean starting point. And first thing we have to do is put the height of the document in, which is 220 millimeters. And the top margin right now is 20 millimeters. And the leading, for the purpose of this first experiment, is 15. And we're saying that the footer margin is going to be 30. Now, I've got a minus number here, but we'll deal with that in a second. This is the interesting thing. I'm just going to, highlight it here. Now type the letter L to convert to outlines. It would be nice if I could actually spell, wouldn't it? Convert to outlines. Okay, in order to get the ascent height, input the value here. Now, what does that mean? What we're going to do is we're going to insert now placeholder text. Okay, and I'm actually going to just add a little bit more just in case we want to do a bit more playing. What's happening right now is that this box has a first baseline of ascent, which is really not a problem. If we had made it leading, then we could make everything fit quite easily. But if we make it leading, then how do we now measure the top of here? If I just draw now a box here, the visual top is really going to be here. It might be here, but it certainly isn't going to be up here. So it's up to you as a designer whether you want to use ascent or leading. So ascent or cap height. You might prefer to use cap height. So this is what it looks like with ascent. This is how I normally do it. Okay, I normally do this. This works for me visually. If you prefer to work let's say with X height, then you're just going to make one slight change. You won't use the letter L here. So let's put it ascent. Now, and what we do is, and here's a little trick, we take the letter L and we convert it to curves. Now, again, if you wanted to do this for the base, if you wanted to do it for the cap, the X height, you just take the letter X. You'd have to type the letter X if you don't have it. And then this value here, and now this is an object, so now I have a value, it's 2.882. Okay, and now I can type this into the yellow box here. Now what we have is we have a full starting point. Now, what does that mean, the starting point? I can now go into my grids and I can say start it at 1.715. That's the value over here in the green box. Don't type anything in the green box. I did that before and I had to redo the entire video. Ruined everything. And now everything is perfectly on the baseline grid. So that means if I take this text and if I now click on, I'm just gonna grab the paragraph panel so you can see it here, and click on, you know, onto align to baseline grid, then everything still fits on baseline grid. Actually, you could do it usually from the top here as well. But we haven't quite solved the bottom bit, and that's really our problem right now. We can get a bit more text on here, as we can see, right? But the bottom of our page, that pink, is not the same. Let's add an extra page for me. How nice. That pink is not the right place. So I need to now make a decision, okay? I now have 32 rows here. Now, I know this by either highlighting all the text and going into my info panel, which is over here. Okay, and I'm moving that back now off to a different screen. Or I'm just looking on my Excel spreadsheet where it now has, says we 32. So do I want to keep to 32? Maybe I want 31. Maybe I want 33. Do whatever I want. Let's say I want 33. Okay, so if I want 33, then the bottom margin is 22.5930. So I can just, I think I can just copy that. I don't know. Let's have a look. So if we could just copy that. Let's see if it works. So mustn't put the millimeters in. So I can copy that. And now you can see that the pink line has gone to the right place. And if I pull this down to the pink line and then add some more text just to prove to you that it works, then we can see it's absolutely perfect. And you can say, very nice. Now, this may be what you desire in terms of the layout. Let's say it is, just for the sake, it's actually not a very good design. I think we should actually change that to 31. That's bothering me now. So now I can just copy that value, and I'm not sure if I can just do paste. I did just paste before. No, it won't allow me to paste. I have to delete the word millimeters. It's a bit strange. And nothing happened. Let's try that again. 33.0763. Okay. And now you see the pink line has gone up by exactly two lines. Fantastic. So you're doing your book, and then what happens? Your client comes along and goes, no, we don't want it to be that big. We want the text to be a little bit smaller. And you say, I've just laid out my entire book. No, but nevertheless, the client is always right, even when they're wrong. So how do we solve this problem? So let's first delete that little L over there. Okay, we're going to delete that. We're going to highlight all of this, and we're going to change the font size to 11.5. Now, it just so happens we want to keep the proportions of the text, and I created this font to have a percentage. So the leading is now 14.375. So let me just quickly put that in here onto my Excel spreadsheet, 4375. And the clients also said that we want a little less space at the top for, I have no idea what reason, because I'm just making this up as I'm going along. So I'm going to put in 18 at the top there. But obviously I have to fix the top layout here to be 18. Okay, so now we can see that we're all over the place. It's like not at all right. But that's okay, because that's all that's changed. We've just changed the 18, we've changed the points. The last thing that we have to change is the X height, because the letter L is now 11.5 points as opposed to 12. So we're going to make another little box here and copy. And I'm going to copy without the word millimeter in there to save you some time. So I'm going to go into this box over here. So now, according to my spreadsheet, if it works, now the last time I did this, it's the second time I'm recording this video, because I did this before and it didn't work, so I can't demonstrate this, it's not working. But let's do this. Let's start with the grid. Control K. Go into the grid, and according to my spreadsheet, I need to put 0.477. Now, by the way, if in the grid dialog, it gives you a minus number, then you're just going to have to add to it another row of leading, but hopefully that won't be a problem. I'm going to increment to 14.375. So hopefully now everything's perfectly on the baseline grid, which it is. And now at the bottom, I'm going to just add lots of text so that you can see this working. So if I want to have the bottom right now, the current number of rows is 34. Okay. So let's make the current number of rows 31. So let's put this value in. So I'm going to do a copy. I think the trick is to press paste and then delete the word in millimeters. Okay. And then pull this up. And as you can see, just on the left-hand page on the verso, let's ignore the right-hand page for the moment. I'm only dealing with this particular page. Oh no, I lie. I'm dealing with both pages at the same time. So we can pull this up as well. And as you can see now, if I now pull this up, we have everything fitting exactly on the baseline grid. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this little video. And if you want the spreadsheet, spelling mistakes and all, I'm actually going to save it and keep that in yellow, then you are very welcome. Just let me know and I'll be very happy to send it to you. And if you have a book that you actually want me to typeset, I'd also be very happy to do that for you. And you can contact me and I will be more than happy to typeset your book, and as you can see, very precisely according to my little calculations that I've made with my little grid calculator. Thank you very much. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments below. And until our next video, I will wish you a wonderful week.